Over the past few years, it has become almost cliche for conservatives to warn about groomers. They're everywhere, apparently, in politics, in business, hiding in the global elites, and certainly in your schools. Now, thankfully, we do have some politicians who are warning against this and trying to get us on our guard against these people who would prey on children. People like perhaps Texas Representative Bryan Slaton, who just, I believe, a week ago tweeted this Bible quote that says, "But whoever causes the downfall of one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for him if a heavy millstone were hung around his neck and were drowned in the depths of the sea." So he's warning against these sorts of people who'd prey on the young. It's also a quote that's used by many on the right to justify the death penalty being used more often. But anyway, the reason he would quote this is because he's a good conservative family man. You can see he's a Christian conservative as well as a proud Texan. You can see him there posing with family. He's also a guy with hobbies, and that's where perhaps we find a problem, because one of his hobbies involves hanging out with his interns. Sorry, one intern. Individually with alcohol. Do you see where I'm going here? There's a complaint filed with the House General Investigating Committee by a legislative staffer obtained by the Texas Tribune, as well as a Tribune source with direct knowledge of the incident, that said that Stanton called his intern, who is under age 21, after 10 p.m. on Friday, you know, prime business hours, to invite her to his apartment where he served her alcohol. But that's not all. According to allegations in the complaint obtained by the Tribune, Slaton later showed that intern fake emails that claimed to have information about the incident in an apparent loyalty test, and told her not to tell anyone about the incident. And here is where that's a real problem. So this 45-year-old, I believe, married guy wants to hang out on the weekend with one of his young interns and give her alcohol, but is also cautioning her to not tell anyone about it and is testing her loyalty. If I was writing like a cliche version of grooming behavior, I kind of feel like this is it. That said, JR, this is a guy who has warned us just a week ago that you should have a millstone hung around your neck if you try to lead one of the little ones astray. I wonder if he'll stick to that position now.
Well, I guess this little one isn't little enough for him to think this is a problem. I mean, they're still, I guess, I assume over 18, but still young, I guess. And honestly, other than that, just the position of power, obviously. You know, even if people say, you know, she's an adult, it's fine outside of, you know, whatever issues that may be happening personally. But then just like when it comes to exactly the positions of power, so then the loyalty tests and all that stuff, yo, that's like your boss, bro. Or, you know, if you want to have a job in this field, if you want to continue on and continue your upward trajectory, and you've worked your whole life to get to this point, and you're hoping that this is the beginning of a career, all that stuff is hanging over folks' head, and you think he doesn't know that? So, I mean, even if you want to cross outside of childhood grooming, this is the basic example of just workplace boss over employee type of behavior. And if you don't do what I like, even though it's all kind, and from his point of view, what he may think, it's pressure on that person to then continue providing whatever it is that he's hoping that she'll provide.
By the way, they say the Texas Republican House Speaker is going to be looking into the accusations. They say take it very seriously, and it is just allegations at this point, so bear that in mind. And also, look, I mean, you could potentially say, like, okay, so he's more than double this person's age, best case scenario. But I guess it could be consensual, although the person did file a complaint, so it seems like there were some actual issues there. But worst case scenario, what is it? It's a guy who's cheating or whatever. It's a private thing. He can do what he wants. No, you can do all of these things. You can say, you can make all of these arguments. He's not making those arguments. That's what I'm saying. He is the one trying to wield his supposed moral purity as a weapon to wield against those he hates or has trained others to hate. That is where the problem actually gets. If you are going to try to present yourself as this moral force, maybe you could try actually living up to it a little bit. And also, if you're a conservative and you're watching this, like, I understand that you think that groomers are like the main threat facing America, other than maybe high school trans athletes or something. Why doesn't it bother you that the pedophiles and the groomers so often turn out to be Republicans or people literally involved in this effort? Why is that not a thing that bothers you? And why is this a thing that he would engage in? It's because, to wrap this up, they say they're against grooming, But they also constantly talk about how people should get married younger and should breed younger. Matt Walsh's whole career is like an attempted VJ was talking about the breedability of 16-year-olds. Because they say groomer as if it's this expansive thing, protect the children. It's not. They're talking about like demonizing the LGBTQ community. That's what they mean. They're talking about what they're certainly not talking about is a middle-aged man trying to hook up with as young as possible a woman. That is protected behavior from their point of view.
Can we go to his banner there with his family and everything and his, sure, I guess his campaign? What is the thing? You see where Bryan is written? What is that? Uh-huh. First, I thought it was like a bullhorn or something. You know, like college cheerleaders will like yell out of the, but it doesn't look like that.
And yeah, those go the other way. Is it a cannon?
Maybe it's a cannon. I was trying to figure what the that circle point is on the left side of it, next to the shape of Texas. The solid circle side. I guess it's a cannon. I was like, in this particular circumstance, I was like, what is that? I don't know.
There are guesses that it's a cannon. It's a joint. It's a broken rolling pin. I don't think it's a broken. Is that of historic significance or something? I don't know. But anyway, look, they're gonna look into it, and it might not be true. I'm just saying, like, man, the more someone yells about this sort of stuff, just dig a little bit, just look into them a little bit, and see what you find. The people who run these forums, the people who run these Telegram groups, so often get found with child pornography and stuff like that. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.